Hello Primary School, welcome to our virtual Friday assembly. Recently, we've had the pleasure of welcoming new learners into our LICS family and even a new teacher in Year 5. But today, instead of welcoming new people, we're needing to say goodbye to two people who are moving on to new adventures. Firstly, we need to say goodbye to Mrs. Garside. She has been an LAA administrator, peripatetic music teacher, and STEM coordinator. Thank you, Mrs. Garside, for your positive impact across the whole primary school, indeed the whole school. You've been a great team player, an adaptable and capable teacher, and your beautiful singing, floating across the quad, is really going to be missed. All the best on your next adventure, and thank you for everything that you have given our community. Then we need to just say goodbye to Mrs. Lucas. But is it just? I say that a lot. Let's just ask Mrs. Lucas. Just let Mrs. Lucas know. Mrs. Lucas will just do it. And yet when I look it up in the dictionary, it says just means barely, only, or by a little. That is not Mrs. Lucas. Mrs. Lucas gives 100% of herself to everything that she does. We've been privileged to have you, Mrs. Lucas, working as a class teacher, a coordinator, the head of SSS, vice principal academic, and as our primary principal. I don't think words could ever explain just how wonderful you are and how much you will be missed. But we're going to give it a try in this assembly. You will also see that there is a link to the Padlet wall in the description for this assembly, should you wish to see the messages to Mrs. Lucas. Do enjoy this assembly, all of you, and Mrs. Lucas in particular. This is for you. Thank you. Firstly, we're going to have a look at a contribution from the house captains and vice captains. They were asked to each take a letter from the words Mrs. Lucas and to put with that letter words and phrases that start with the letter that describe what Mrs. Lucas is like and what she means to them. Enjoy.
Thank you very much, house leaders, for those wonderful adjectives describing Mrs. Lucas. Well done. Well, sadly, we are saying bye to Mrs. Lucas, everyone. And I just want to say a few things about Mrs. Lucas. We are sad to say goodbye to a wonderful teacher and principal. Mrs. Lucas has been in Zambia for 15 years, for those of you who didn't know. And 8 of those years have been spent with us at LICS. That tells you what it means for her to be a member of the LICS community. And I'm sure it's hard for her even to be going at this time. In those years, she came in as a class teacher and she was teaching Year 3, I remember very well. And I took over the same class that she was teaching. And then she moved on to literacy coordinator and was making sure that all the resources and the English we're teaching the children were according to the Cambridge curriculum. And quickly, she moved on to the coordinator for the SSS department. So the special education needs coordinator. Again, very quickly, she moved on and she became vice principal. Academic, and that was the very first time LICS ever had that position. So well done to Miss Lucas. And then she quickly moved on to primary principal, a role that she's held up to this time when we're saying goodbye. Well, what can we say about Miss Lucas as we say goodbye to her? We remember her as a hard worker, a team player. Yes, she worked hard, but she worked within teams, working with all our colleagues and ensuring that we deliver what we do best, that's teaching and learning. She was always looking for improving the ways that we teach, and I think that I remember very well. She always wanted us to improve the teaching, the lessons that we are delivering at LICS, and the teaching quality. And she was never satisfied with the status quo. Well done, we'll remember her for that. And because of that, Mrs. Lucas was interested in seeing what other schools are doing so that we could innovate. And so I remember visiting South Africa and visiting some schools, St. John's and St. Peter's, with her together to look at what we were doing. And in fact, we came back so excited because we found that we were just a notch higher in certain areas than those schools there. And of course, we finished that visit with a visit to the AISA conference. And then she's also gone to the Cambridge conference, all the time learning and wanting to improve what we do. We will remember her with all those wonderful things that she's done for the school. One of the key highlights, even as we visited other schools, was tracking of learners' progress. And Mrs. Lucas introduced Insight to LICS. And we now can track the children as soon as they arrive at LICS up to the time they leave, and we are able to see whether they're making progress, and if they're making slower progress, we accelerate it by helping them, and anyone who's doing so well, we keep encouraging them, and that informed our reporting. A great program, and I think in our trips around Southern Africa, we found that there were very few schools that had Insight, probably one other and then LICS. So well done to Ms. Lucas for that. But let me end by saying some very touching words. As a colleague who worked at LICS, she made friends with all of us. And she's a friend indeed to a lot of people. Mrs. Lucas had a favorite spot, and that was the Relay Lodge. And that was one of her favorite spots over the weekend. And I think she will miss that little place there. But one colleague has written a wonderful thing about Miss Lucas, and I want to end with this. One of the teachers says, "Without your guidance, encouragement, and support, I wouldn't be a teacher and the person I am today. I am profoundly grateful to you and will miss you immensely." Wow. That's true about all of us, Miss Lucas. Farewell. We're not parting forever. I'm sure our paths will cross in future professionally and, of course, socially. We will all miss you. So from all of us, from deep down in our hearts, have a wonderful stay in your next posting. Bye.
It's hard to imagine that this is my last assembly. LICS has been a part of my life for so, so many years. I've seen so many learners pass through the school. The first year group I ever taught are now year 11. Imagine that. And some of you weren't even born when I started. LICS is a really dear place to me, and I'm going to miss it. It's a special place. You should feel proud of it. Treasure it. I wrote a poem about what makes LICS special to me. This is all the things that I will remember about what makes LICS so special. As a community, we are creative, innovative, able and inspiring, cheerful, playful, confidently smiling, with perseverance, dedication, grit and resilience, greeting, supporting, celebrating brilliance. A community diverse, collaborative and connected, global citizens together, equally respected. With the arts, sports, planned afternoon activities, singing, dancing, primary production and nativity, Reverse Santa, Culture Week, Food Day, Parade of Nations, discos, house events, assemblies and graduations, Literacy Day, Math Science Week, dress up and book sales, round robin experiments, fundraising, EOP and maths trails, Siabonga, Choma, Wild Tracks, exploring the outdoors, carnival, bare feet theatre, visitors and sports tours, ARP, TT Rockstars, Numbots, Student Council, House Captains, Checkpoint, Million Word Club, always maximising potential. It is all of this and so much more that makes LIC so special and what I adore. Saying goodbye is never easy, and at the risk of sounding just a little bit cheesy, thank you all to the LIC's community and the family that I have been a part. I will miss you all from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Lucas. We really will miss you. We're going to leave the end of the assembly to all of our primary learners. They have been working hard drawing pictures of you, Mrs. Lucas. We hope you enjoy them and all the best on your adventures.
the windows and the sound of drums. People couldn't believe what I'd become.